Hi guys, this is Yamiki91. In today's video I want to showcase my update of the Dark Lord deck. As we can see from the list, the deck is changed a bit due to the fact that now the Sanctify of Dark Lords is limited and the contact is semi-limited, so we need to change a little bit the deck, especially also because the skill beatdown is nerfed, so you can only use one time in a duel, so I think it's better to swift to another skill. It has to play the deck with the Ties That Binds. That is a good skill in general because it can boost all your monsters. And since since Dark Lords have a big monsters, you are able to get over the 3000 threshold. That is a very important threshold in order to get over the Cochitus and other big monsters in the meta. For the monster lineup, I decided to maintain, of course, one copy of Dark Lord Desire. This is a very good boss monster. It helps you to deal with a lot of monsters, so it's very good. Three copies of Ixchel for draw power, of course. One Superbia, because you need no other special summon a monster in attack position. Two Nasten, as always. Two copies of Tez. This time I decided to play two copies of this card, because you need two monsters that have a high attack. This is the one that is higher attacks besides from the Lucifer and the Desire, so this is a very good card to play in my opinion for this reason. Then one copy of Morningstar, the Lucifer. This is a very good card because it helps you to push for an OTK, put a lot of monster in the deck into the field, and also mill depending on any of the number of Dark Lord monster you have on the field, and gain life points consequently. So it's a very good card in order to recover your life points and try to TK. So I decided to play this card, and I think it's a very good option to play in the deck. Then one copy of Amdusk in order to recover any card you need from the graveyard, so it's another good option to recover. One Ukoback, as always. Then for the spell lineup, I decided to play 3 copies of Banishment. Now this card is very needed. You need to play 3 copies of it in order to make the deck more consistent. One copy of Cosmic Cyclone in order to deal with back row is an option. Then 2 copies of Dark Lord Contact. Of course now it's semi-limited, you need to play only 2. This card you need to play at 2. Then for the trap lineup, one Wall of Disruption. I decided to play this card because it's, in general it's kinda good. The only problem is Cochitus, of course, but you need to play at least one trap card in order to be able to have protection for any situation in which you are not able to make plays, and this is a good option. Then of course the one copy of Sanctify Dark Lord, because it's limited, of course. So for the skill I played, the Ties That Binds, as I said. This is my list. If you have any suggestions, let me know in the comment section below, and we will see in the next video.